Welcome back to the show. An Australian woman caught up in a deadly bus crash in southern Italy is speaking out against a popular international travel company after she was left stranded for 9 hours and was only offered a $16 meal voucher following the ordeal.
Terrible stuff. Let's bring in Sinead Curry, who joins us live now from Rome. Sinead, thanks so much for your time. We're so sorry to hear what you went through. How are you holding up?
Thanks so much for having me, Carl and Sarah. We're not holding up well. None of us are okay.
What happened?
We were all asleep roughly 2 hours into our journey and the bus hit something. I was clinging on to my partner's arm as I was sleeping and she was holding on to something. And so we flew around. Basically, everyone was tossed out of our seats. We feel we were upside down at least once. The bus seemed to roll and then it landed on its side down an embankment. And when it landed, the right side of the bus, all the windows smashed on the grass and the mud. And so we were able to crawl, like dig out through the mud and pull ourselves out through the glass of the broken window. And then other people were helped to get out if they were trapped in the vehicle as well. The passengers were helping each other.
Sinead, it sounds absolutely awful. I mean, you're in a foreign country, which already poses communication issues. What did they do to try and help you? Was there much communication happening?
No. Immediately after the crash, everyone was crying and screaming in their own native language. There are people speaking at least four different languages who were affected in the 36 passengers on board. We were all trying to help each other just to call the police. We didn't know the Italian police number, so we gave our phone to an Italian girl who called them for us and she was chatting to them for about 8 minutes. We hit an existing accident, so there were already three cars on the road apparently. But as we were crawling to get out of the wreckage, another two cars hit the bus, so we weren't safe sheltering under the bus. We also weren't safe near the road, so we were all trying to help each other. In terms of translation, we were hospitalised and all of it was in Italian. Only one of the nurses spoke a little bit of broken English. So we leant on Google Translate functions to just try and tell them what hurt and to show them like where the pain is. So, for example, I'm still in pain in my face, my nose and the back of my head, as well as my neck and my back. And we just had to point to the areas that hurt so they would x-ray us.
Do you know, this is like every, you know, parent's nightmare when their kids go travelling overseas, you know, the lack of communication and exactly what you've experienced. And we're really sorry for what you've gone through. This was a deadly crash as well. Were you able to be assisted by the consulate at all or DFAT or anyone to help you through this and to help you get home?
On the first day, we tried for 8 hours to contact the consulate and we finally got through. They weren't able to help us on day one because we hadn't lost our passports and we had made contact with our loved ones. But then on day two yesterday, we were contacted by a different member of the Australian Embassy here in Rome who was able at least to translate via phone to a hospital in Rome, because we had to go back to hospital, what our injuries were. So we're grateful for that assistance.
So yeah. What was the company and how do you feel about the way that they've treated you?
The company was Flixbus and their response has honestly just been too little too late at every single turn. So, for example, the bus crash happened at around 3:45 a.m. We didn't hear from them until 7:43 and it was an automated text that said, "We hear you've been in a crash. Hope you're okay. Here's a €10 meal replacement and non-alcoholic beverage replacement voucher." Then we heard nothing until 9:13 a.m. and the tech said, "There's a replacement Flixbus on its way to get you to your destination." And all of us were terrified. We were still in hospital. We were not going to get on the bus. Then we received messages in Italian around 9:13 and also 11 a.m. telling customers to contact a number, but the number was incorrect and it rang out for all of us on all different phones. Around 1:15 p.m. I found out that someone from Flixbus or one of the drivers had been able to give a statement, and I was furious because at that point we had just arrived at Grotta Minarda and the fire and search rescue teams had taken us in and given me some clothes. But we had
Sinead, we're going to make some calls from this end as well. We'll come back to you in the next 24 hours. Yeah. But look, we're glad you're all right. I know you're shaken and pretty cut up about it all. We appreciate you being on. Thank you.
Yeah, what an ordeal.